Even if your level uses nanite, you'll likely have meshes with transparent materials. For example, this static mesh uses a transparent glass material, and because of this tiny part of the mesh, if you try to enable nanite, it won't render properly. Nanite doesn't work with static meshes that have transparent materials. But don't worry, there are a few tricks to make them perform better. This mesh already has LODs set up, which is an important step. But I won't focus on that since there are plenty of tutorials out there on how to set up LODs. So, how can we further optimize performance? Rendering transparent materials is more demanding than rendering opaque materials. The easiest way to boost performance is to adjust the last LODs by swapping the transparent material for an opaque one already on the mesh. This significantly reduces rendering costs. You can also use a more suitable alternative material to replace the transparent one. After applying this method, we can run a stress test to measure performance gains. The improvements are noticeable, but there might be another way to optimize further. The second method is to use nanite, but how can we do that if it doesn't support traditional transparency? The solution is to split the model in two, one for the opaque part and one for the transparent part. You can do this in your 3D modeling software, such as Blender, while keeping the same pivot position. Now we can create an actor blueprint and add a static mesh component for the opaque part. Add another static mesh component for the transparent part and assign the corresponding mesh. You can set a desired max draw distance for further optimization. Since the transparent part might not be visible from a distance, it doesn't need to be rendered. Finally, it is to set the mobility to static for the blueprint route and the static mesh components. Now, let's compare performance improvements using a stress test. As you can see, this setup is a significant improvement over the initial mesh configuration. A practical example is constructing a building with interior. When creating the modular pieces for the structure, exclude the glass part in the base mesh. Instead, spawn the glass mesh separately on the modular piece that utilizes nanite. Additionally, there is a specific optimization case for meshes that consists solely of a transparent material. For example, with this bottle, you can set the desired max draw distance in the details panel of the static mesh actor. Since the bottle is small and transparent, it is likely to be less visible at a distance, making this adjustment beneficial for performance. Now, in the stress test, we can see that performance improves directly based on the number of meshes culled by distance. These optimizations may not drastically improve performance in your scene, as my tests were intentionally exaggerated to highlight the differences. However, making small improvements across all aspects of your level can lead to a significant overall performance boost. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions or want to share your own optimization tips, feel free to drop a comment below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Thanks for watching. Thank you.